Hi guys, welcome to Absence Pro. Welcome to another Shopify tutorial video. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can connect your Shopify store with multiple sales channel, and that includes Google Merchant Center and Facebook catalog. So the first question you might be thinking is that why should I connect that? Because it's a free listing available via Google and Facebook, and you can get more sales using these platforms completely for free. And it's really good for SEO as well. So it's really important for you to connect these platforms with your Shopify store. And I'm going to show you how with very easy step-by-step process. And if you don't know what is the Google Merchant Center and what's the difference between the Google Merchant Center listing and the normal listing in Google search, let me show you what's that. So as you can see, I have searched for Nike Air Zoom. These are the Nike shoes. And that's the normal listing where your website link is showing up, right, with the pricing and stuff. And now I want to show you guys the Google Merchant Center listing, and that's how Google Merchant listing looks like, where you can see we have these color filters showing up, we have these styling, and we have these stylish looking product cards showing up. So that's coming from the Google Merchant Center. You can see we have these 360 pictures which we can upload in Google Merchant Center, of course. And in order to submit your products to display like these listing, you will have to connect your Shopify store with Google Merchant Center listing and prepare a feed and submit it to Google Merchant Center so your products can be indexed and displayed like this. And in this video, I'm going to show you, which is super simple, and we will be doing that via an app called Product Feed Sync, FeedFusion. And this basically helps you connect multiple platforms in one single app. You don't have to create, you don't have to learn how to create different feeds, because all of the platforms have different attributes and different format of the feed which they accept. And it's really hard for you to go one by one on every single platform and connect your Shopify store with those. But using this app, we can connect all in one. And I'm going to show you in this video how to do that in the Google Merchant Center, and super simple way to do that. And the good thing about it, this app, is that it comes with a free tier. So if you have 100 products or 200 variants, you can connect this with any of these two platforms like Google, Facebook. I think these are the main platforms, and connecting these platforms is really important. If you have more than two platforms, if you want to create multiple feeds, you can go to the paid tier, but obviously you can get a lot of stuff done with the free tier as well. So make sure to try that out. I'll put the link in the description. I've already installed that app in my development store. And that's how the app page looks like when you install that on your store. And first, we're going to go over the integration part. So if you click on integrations, you have this option to connect the Google Merchant Center. And here you have the option to connect Meta Business Account, which is Facebook business account as well, right? So first, let me show you how simple it is to connect Google Merchant Center. So I'm just going to click on Google Merchant Center. You can see I already connected that, but it's showing disconnected. So I'm going to show you guys how you can connect it by reconnecting the account. I'm going to simply click on add account. And here I am going to select the email address where I want my Merchant Center to be connected, and then click on continue. And then click on this checkbox here, and then click on continue. Okay, you can see that our Google Merchant Center account has been connected. And now we will create our first data feed. So data feed is a list of products which you have on your store, which will be synced with Google Merchant Center. If you update anything on your store, it's going to automatically be updated on the Merchant Center as well. Doing that manually is really a pain. So I have this Google Merchant Center open, and this is one of our clients. And if I click on products, you can see the products are being listed here. We have this error showing up due to the privacy policy. You just need to ignore that. You can see that that's how the products are being submitted to Google Merchant Center. And if you change anything on your Shopify store, you'll have to then manually update that or generate a new feed. But this app gonna do that automatically. So you will just create the feed and it automatically sync that with Google Merchant Center. Now let's click on create data feed to create on the new feed. So you can see the name, feed name, you can name it whatever you want. I'm going to just leave it to default. And that's the Google Merchant Center ID. Now make sure that this ID should be matching with your Google Merchant Center ID. So let's suppose you have a Google Merchant Center account, or you have multiple Google Merchant Center account. Make sure that it's matching with this ID, just like I have it here. Currently, I am showing you the demo, so I don't have the Google Merchant Center account created separately for this development store, but just in order to show you guys that you should match this ID with this ID here. Once you do that, you will just select on the target market, whatever your target market is. Let's suppose my target market is United States. I'm just gonna go to United States, then select the primary language of your store. And here's the schedule of how often it's going to sync with your merchant center. So if you are changing your products, pricing and all of that on daily basis, you can simply click on daily. Or if you want your products to be synced on a weekly basis, you can simply click on weekly basis. Here we have the product filter, that's optional. So make sure to select products and variants. And here we have the shipping option. Here we have the country code showing up. Here we have the pricing for shipping. Here we have the region. And here we have the services which we will be using for shipping. That is also going to be showing up when you open the product in Google Merchant Center. So if I open any of the product here, just like this one here, you can see that this card is displaying all of the details like reviews, size, and it's also going to show the shipping if I further click on that product. So you can see that we have this $10 delivery, 28 days return. So all of the details are being pulled via Google Merchant Center. And your product will also be displayed if you connect your store with Google Merchant Center. So once done, all you have to do is just click on create here. So that's the create button after filling up all of the feed details. Okay, now I'm gonna click on create button. And here the sync has started. Now it has started creating the feed, which it will automatically sync with the Google Merchant Center. This process might take a few minutes, but it should be quick as I don't have much products on the store. Okay guys, you can see that our feed has been successfully synchronized with the Google Merchant Center, and this is the feed which has been generated. That's how the XML feed looks like. So if I'm gonna open that, let me show you guys how it actually looks. So that's how the XML feed looks like, and it is now automatically submitted to Google Merchant Center and synced, and it will automatically be updated on a weekly basis. Now if you go to Google Merchant Center and go to data sources, and if I refresh now, you can see that our new feed has been submitted to Google Merchant Center, and it's showing the file URL which we submitted. Now I'm going to remove that because this is just for the demo purposes. So I am just going to delete that because it was just for the demo purposes in order to show you guys how it actually submits the feed. Okay, we have created the feed. Now we can also create additional feeds. So if we go to feeds, we can create additional feeds as well for the different platforms. And even if we want to create different feeds for one single platform, we can do that as well. So there will be multiple data sources showing up here. If I open up the feed, we have some other options here as well. One of the option is that image resizing option, which is also a really important feature. So every single platform, let's suppose Facebook, Google, they have different image requirements. Their platform supports different image sizes, but this app is going to resize that automatically. And they have few methods. So the first thing is it's saying original image, that it's not going to change the image size, and it's going to submit the actual product picture as it is without changing anything. The second option which we have is Shopify cropping, which is the Shopify CDN to crop the image. And here we have the option of image size, which automatically resize the image as per the platform requirement. So let's suppose platform requires 400 by 400 pixel, it's going to automatically resize that. And here we have the option to resize it with the custom option, that if we want to add the custom width and custom height for our product picture to be displayed on Google Merchant Center, we can add the width and height. Here we have the alignment option. So if we want to display the right side of the image, left, on the custom image size. If we click on smart resizing, it's going to transform the image using AI and move the object to the focus. So let me give you an example of this image. So I'm going to play this video to show you guys. So currently this video is a little bit right aligned, but AI operation on the back end gonna transform this image to be center aligned and make the object of the image to be focused. So that's a really good thing with the smart resizing, which you will be getting. Let's explore some of the features of the app where we have this option here where we can select which item is in the feed. It's showing up which items are in the feed, right? And if we go to the template tab, here we have the attributes which we can map with Google Merchant Center. Now, these are all of the Shopify fields which is mapping to these fields. Now, really good thing about the app is that we can also map the custom meta fields. Now, custom meta fields are showing up below here. So these are, you can see the meta fields. These are the product meta fields and these are the variant meta fields. So you can basically map all of that custom data as well, which is not available by default or any other app. So that's a really good feature. And we can also create calculated fields. Let me show you how the calculated fields work. So if I click on this calculation fields, let me open that in a new tab. I am going to create a new calculation field. Now I'm assuming you are submitting Google Merchant Center feed and you want to increase or decrease a price based on the sales channel. Now you want to add additional 5% to Google Merchant Center. If you get any sales, you will be charging 5% additional. You can do that as well. Okay, so here I am going to click on variance and then let's rename it to additional price and then click on create. And now in this example, we'll be adding $5 additional to the actual price of the product. So let's select this attribute here, then click on this operator to add an additional amount. And there here we will add five. And now the actual price of the product will be $5 additional to our feed, which we will be submit to Google, right? And once this field is created, I'm gonna click on save. And after creating this calculated field, let's go back to the feeds and let's hit refresh here. And let's go to that feed, go back to the template. And from price, here we have mapped with the price. So these are the fields of Google Merchant Center and these are the fields of Shopify which we are mapping. Now we are mapping price field of Google Merchant Center with the field which we have additionally created by the name of additional price. So I'm going to search that field, where it is. Here it is. So here we have this calculation field showing up by the name of additional price, right? So that's how easy it is to create the calculated field and then map it to the field where we want to. And here we have the option to create additional fields. We can do that as well if we want to create an additional field. And we have now the upload option as well. In upload option, we can basically select the FTP method where we will be adding host username and password to upload via FTP method. So if we go to data sources and click on add product source, we have these options where we can do the SFTP method as well. So if we click on add a file using SFTP method and click on view SFTP in Google storage, we will be adding this server, port, fingerprint, username details on our this upload feed here, where it will be automatically uploading the field to the Google Merchant Center. Here we have the option of Google Analytics, where we can basically get the tracking of how many visits we are getting on our product and what is the campaign source, etc., etc. And all of these are Google Analytics, which you can use if you want to have advanced ranking for your Google Merchant Center feed. Now, let's go back to the filter. Here we have the filter option that if we want to filter out the products which we want to sync in the feed. So if we click on filters and add a new filter, we'll be able to add a new filter where we can simply filter out those products which we don't want to submit on our Google Merchant Center feed. So if you are not looking to submit low stock products, you can simply create a new filter here where it will check that if the product is low in stock, it is not going to include that in the feed. So here we have the status active. We will select here, exclude disabled product. It's not going to include the disabled product in the feed. It's not going to include the out of stock product. It is going to include all collection. You can also select the specific collection. If there is any of the collection which you do not want to include, you can simply unselect that collection. Here we have the option to select the product, which products you want to select or not. So here we can simply create these rules and filter out those products which we don't want to include in our merchant center feed. Okay, now let's go over the data mapping feature. And in data mapping, we will be able to map our collection with a category field in the Google Merchant Center. So if I open up the Google Merchant Center, let's go back to the dashboard of the Google Merchant Center. So that's how the products are looking like in the Google Merchant Center, right? And if I added any of the product, like this one, for example, and scroll down to categories, so these are the categories, right? And these are the predefined categories of the Google Merchant Center. We are unable to add new category fields. We'll just have to select one of the fields. What we can do here is create a new mapping. So let's go to add mapping and name it my mapping, click on create. And now here we will simply add in the category name, and that will tell the feed that this specific collection is mapped to that category. So if I add in this decorative stickers here, all of the products in all products collection going to display this decorative stickers category in my Google Merchant Center. So that's how the Google mapping works, and make sure to apply to the specific field. I currently have only one feed, so it's showing up this one here. If you have multiple feeds like Facebook, Instagram, or any other feed, you can simply check mark those feed and map those collection to those specific categories as per the requirement of that platform. And I think that's pretty much it for the features of this app. A lot of features which you will be getting in this app, and these are the really important features if you want to increase sales of your store via multiple sales channel. And integrating them manually, it's really a pain, which is made easier by FeedFusion product app, and you should definitely use it. Link of the app will be in the description. Let me know in the comments below if you have any feedback for the video. Would love to answer all of your comments. And until next video, have a great day.